Okay, hi guys, Zero here, and there's another quick tutorial on the our kimono series we've been doing. So let me try to start this over. Hi everyone, and welcome to another Ginkgo tutorial. My name is Zero, and I'll be your teacher for today. This is actually an add-on tutorial for the kimono series we've been doing. It got so popular that we actually got a donation of the BB and MM Thunder Thighs and Boobies. The person who sent us a copy of it was having a hard time working with the dev kit because it's actually in two parts. The creator gives you a copy of the kit to work and make clothes with, but she puts the... or I'm assuming it's a she, they put the boobs in one file and the thighs in the other file, and you know, it's really a pain in the butt to try to make it, because you have to make the top part in one file and then the bottom part in the other, and if you append them, the files together, you got two different skeletons, and it's still the same thing as having it being separate. So it was kind of a pain in the butt, and I understand. So I decided to build a whole new dev kit that combines the boobs and the thighs together so that you can easily make clothes for this add-on. The process is pretty much the same as the last stuff. We're going to put together the mannequin, the dummy file, you know, the boobs, the body, and everything else, and export it, put it in Marvelous, make some clothes, and then rig it and bring it into Second Life. So that's pretty much the scope of this tutorial. So I guess now that I explained all that, I'm just gonna jump in and start showing you how to do what I just explained. So we're gonna open up Blender, and I'm using 2.70 this time. I thought I was on 2.72. No, well, it doesn't really matter. I made it in 2.70, so you can make it in anything 2.70 and up. But the older ones are great. Stick with that. Don't use 7.7. Okay. So here we go. We have, when you open up the dev kit, you'll just see a bunch of bones. And I did this on purpose because I want you to be able to build your kimono for what you're using. I didn't want to just have a default one there and it might confuse you. So this is actually the first time we're going to be using group sets in my tutorials. So I want you to turn your attention over here to this side where all the groups are. And you'll see I named everything in the best of my ability. And they're all eyed out. What I mean by eyed out is the eye is closed. So when you want to start building your kimono, you're just going to click on the eye and build the parts that you're wearing. Simple, huh? I even added in the head and some hair and the ears and the tail, so you have a full kimono avatar here and not working with just a partial thighs and bust, because that's just stupid, isn't it? Alright, so let's build our kimono. I'm going to go back in Second Life real quick, sorry, and see which one I'm wearing. I'm wearing large boobies and medium thunder thighs with the animal feet. So let's see if I can remember that. I have large boobies, so breast type. You know, I swore I named these a lot better than what they are here. Alright, so let's just try this. Kimono mouth, kimono eyelid, tail, shades, no skull. Hey, what did I... default kimono... You know, I could have swore I made this up. Oh, there we go. That's why I closed the avatar thing. That's better. Sorry about that. Alright, so I have large bosoms and what is this? Animal feet, animal thunder thighs, number medium, so that's like two thunder thighs, two animal feet, two. There we go. So that's my avatar here. And I'm gonna look for my arms, kimono arms. And I want a skull because I hate working on stuff without a head. And I want mouth number two because it just seems like funny. I don't think I need the eyelids or anything like that, but it's kind of creepy without it. No eyelids. So basically, you're just clicking on the eyes and building up your kimono however you want it. If you wanted to put the tail, you would just put the tail, not the tail cluster, because that's all the tails. Right there, tails, and you see, kimono butt. And if you want ears or just the default bust, all that jazz is right there. So this is the rough, this is my avatar that I'm wearing in Whirl. Alright, no, I can't use that mouth. It's just, right? So let me see. Ooh. There we go. Teasing. Alright, so there we go. That's less creepy. So we have our avatar here. And because her thighs have so much thunder in it and they're pushing together, I'm going to spread them apart just a little bit. And that's by pressing, clicking on the bone and pressing R. Spread them apart just a bit. Just so they're not going to stick together and marvelous. Alright, so now we have our avatar here. It's pretty much going on from what we did in the previous tutorial. Go into object mode, click on the parts, hold down shift as I select everything that I want to export, head in jaw. You can move it to see if everything's been selected. Once it has, we can just press Control Z, put it back into place. And I'm going to go up to the top and go File, Export a regular Kalata Day. And I'm just going to save it kimono with head 22. Okay. I'll check that out later. And then we're going to make sure it's dot day. And I'm going to hit export. I'm going to pause it real quick and see what that question was about. So be right back. 1 second. Okay. Sorry about that. Somebody was asking about the Matria body. Alright, so actually I made a mistake when I exported this. I just exported it as a day and I didn't do the right thing. If I was to import it into Marvelous, it's going to crash that way. So if your mom, you push export and your Marvelous crash, sorry, that's my fault. I forgot to show you. So you're going to select the parts that you want to export. Again, not selecting the bones. And you're going to go over to File, Export, Kalata default day, and you're going to go to your operator presets and do SL open sim static. I forgot you need to check that box before you export, and I'm just going to use the same kimono head 22 and then press export. So once the model is exported, we're going to go and open up Marvelous. So I'm going to say yes to that, and I'm gonna pause and I'll be right back when Marvelous is all done. Well, no, actually, I guess I didn't have to pause it at all. It just loaded right up. So when you open Marvelous, you'll see default avatar, and we don't want her anymore. We're just going to go over the side and go File, Open, Avatar, and then select the kimono head 22 and scale 100. Say OK, and there she goes. All right, so this is our kimono avatar, and I'm just going to press new. I already explained a billion and one times on how to use Marvelous, so I think you guys get it now. If not, check out my other tutorials. I made them with love. So I'm just going to make a quick suit here. Nothing fancy. Whoops. So, to pants. And go down the leg, only because I'm a sadist. Making this thing so big. Okay, so maybe to here. And one more. And now we're just gonna unflip the side. Copy, paste, flip. Bring it on back, and then we're going to sew all of this together. My poor baby, listen, my computer die. I really need to clean my system out, or at least clean the fan out. I bet that's it. It's dog days of summer, and I'm burning my poor baby up. So I guess this is a fine time to say that I'm actually not going to be around for a bit. My favorite game is about to come out, the Zero Time Dilemma. I'm sure you guys seen the wallpaper on the back of, you know, my computer. Creepy artistic one. Yeah, that's Zero. Oh, I'm so excited. Waited 4 years for that game to come out. 4 years. That's like one hell of a cliffhanger. That's what they did. It left us on a cliffhanger. And then they were like, well, we're going to release the game back in 2014. And then it got canceled because Japan didn't like it. So the U.S. has been like, we need this game in our lives. Finish it. So they finally decided to finish it. And that's going to happen in another two days. So when that happens, I'm going to be dead to the world. So if you try to reply or ask me a question between June 28th and possibly July 8th, because I'm going to dedicate all my life to this game, I probably won't be answering you. So don't be offended if I don't reply back to you. I'm just lost in this game. I got like 4 years of unanswered questions to settle. And then I think after I finish playing, I'm going to just die for a while and take it all in. Or be like one of those angry people writing on there like, oh my God, why? Why did that happen? That makes no sense. Something like that. So that's what I'm meant to tell you guys. I think I'll tell to you a bit while I'm doing all this sewing. Which is what I'm doing. I'm just segment sewing the parts together. Too many seams, actually. This really doesn't need that many parts. Alright. That's everything all sewn together. And I may make it a little bit bigger. Just because. Alright. Now we sew. Wow, look at that. Good on the first go. Only minimum F up. So hang on 1 second. The guy replied back. So let me go answer that question. I'll be right back. Okay, sorry about that. So I'm going to make the sleeves a little bit bigger because I don't like all that. And I don't feel like editing it in Blender too much. So just grab those, hold down shift, drag it down a wee bit, and probably could have got away with just pulling it. Didn't have to make it that big. So I'm gonna do a little more adjusting. Come on, hang on, I'll be right back again. Okay, so here we go. We have a nice bodysuit for the kimono, nice and tight, and for the most part not sticking through anywhere. So we're gonna just export it like we do always, you know, file, export, OBJ. I'm gonna save this as test to alpha because that sounds super cool. I'm gonna press the M and unify coordinates, close collapse triangles, deselect everything. Let's make this a little bit bigger and only check the cloth shape. We don't need any of that. And then hit OK. So it's all exported and we're gonna head right back over to Blender. So I'm just gonna close this. And don't need to save that. See? Zero Time Dilemma. Oh my God, game's so good. And go back into Blender. So now we're here in Blender. We got our mannequin still smiling creepily up there. I'm gonna put the 3D cursor in the middle. I guess it's just habit. And go over to a new layer. Then we're going to import it. So import OBJ, test suit alpha. Enable that layer again. So I'm going to click on the garment, hold down shift, click on the bones. I usually go for the eye bones because they're like the easiest to grab because, you know, they're sticking out like 40 inches away from the face. So you know, garment, hold down shift, click on the bones, go over to the Avastar tab on the side, click alter to shape recipes. I think you uncheck shape sliders for this one, and then assign armature. So let's see how that works. And while it is like this, I am going to select. Oh, for my God! Stop asking me questions. Hang on. Okay, I'm pretty sure this is what I did last time. What I like to do when I have something like a one-piece bodysuit is I like to combine all the pieces together. Since I'm not exporting the body or anything, I don't have to worry about any texture things. I wouldn't recommend selecting a head, so we're just going to select the parts of the body, like these down here. And I'm just going to go to tools and then join them together. And that makes it easier to grab all the weight and stuff off of it when I'm, you know, doing this. So here is my body. Whoa, that is a lot of clipping. All right, so we have our body. I'm gonna go to, I'm all over the place. All right, let me start over. All right, so you're going to click the body first. Don't know why I didn't think of closing my messenger. Alright, so, sorry about that. Guess I'm really popular today. Every time I pick up the mic, somebody calls me. Alright, so like I was saying, you're going to click on the body, hold down shift, click on the garment, then go into weight paint mode, and you're going to pick transfer weights. And it should be all, nearest face, all. When you have a blender that's higher, like 2.73 and up, they give you more options and stuff, so I can't really tell you which is the better of them to use, because, you know, I don't use it. So I may get some sticky legs, which I absolutely hate. I don't understand why anyway, but it happens. We can just fix it, because, you know, we're awesome like that. We showed you how to deal with sticky legs. So what we are going to do is press R, rotate out, rotate it a little more, select the garment, find, let's start with this bone, right here, and we're going to press the face select, select the triangle, turn the weight up, make it hot, make all the triangles that are supposed to be on that side hot. And then make the ones that are on the opposing side cold, because they ain't got no business over here. So let's pull this away for just a second. Alright, so what are we doing now? We're going to press the M again, select another bone, press M again to go back into masking. Since we're already over this side, let's make this hot. Now snap over. And we're just going to grab those and make these cold. Because, like I said, they have no business trying to go on that side of the leg. Ta-da! And that's how you deal with sticky legs with masking. So, here we basically have as our kimono rig thingamabob. Yeesh! Them weights. Them weights ain't good. It may need some manual weight painting. I'm pretty sure that ain't right, so I'm just gonna make that cold and then pull this one out, make it cold. That cold, because it, again, it ain't supposed to be there. Let's see, maybe that's still going to the pelvis. There we go. And if you ever wonder, like, what's pulling it, just look in, like, when you're moving a leg, the triangles will try to go towards the joint that has the most heat on it. So that's how I was able to see, like, the pelvis must have had something to it, because it was pointing towards the middle. And we already cleaned up this side, so obviously it was the pelvis. So if you get stuck with that, you know, you can always keep that little tip in mind. It may help you. So let's try bending the upper part. Yeesh. Reduce this a little bit. Well, it's really for bodysuit, stuff like that don't matter. As long as it bends right, you can always alpha that out in world, right? I forgot to rig the head to the actual skeleton, so it won't move. Whoops, let's put it back. And I guess that's good enough. Whoops, make that hot. All Alright, so we have it. And we are going to correct this a little bit because that drives me bananas. Scoop mode here and make this a little bigger. Giving myself a little more bust. Alright, so once we have it all fixed, we're just going to export it. So click on the garment and the garment alone, no bones, no mesh. I'm going to go file, export, Avastar. What this is, kimono test alpha .da and export. So now we have that exported, let's go back over to Second Life and I'm going to file, upload mesh. That's my snaggle junk. I guess it would help if I actually see where I saved it to. So I'm gonna try this again. Avastar documents. Documents. How fancy. Never save anything in my documents. So kimono test alpha. You know the drill. Lowest and low. Include skin weight. Calculate fees. And it's worn. Will it work? Oh, guess it'll help if I'll put where. In a minute now. Damn beta grid. Hang on 1 second. Alright, damn beta grid. I hate when it's laggy like this. Chuck, 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 chuck. But it could mean I have to clear my cache out. I guess I should have did that before the tutorial. So there we go. It's there. And I'm gonna make it blue. And we have our kimono bodysuit. Now, yeah, of course, you know, parts are chipping through because I didn't do any kind of cleaning on it, but adjusting it, but as you see, it fits like a glove. I feel like, what is that game? Soul Calibur. Like, this could really be Taki's Player 2 old costume if we wanted it to be. So yeah, that's how you make clothes for the kimono. What is this? The kimono? You can neck off for the kimono thing. Sorry, the BBMM kimono boobie thing in my bobbers. That's how you make clothes for it. And I'm just gonna quickly walk and see if everything actually stuck together. It's looking good except for right there, but you know I could fix that and wait. So we're just no. I think I may have to actually weight that properly. But with some minor weight painting, that's pretty much how you can fix it. Did that help? Did you guys get the gist of how to make clothes for them? Or was this tutorial too over the place and I need to redo it? Oh, please say it wasn't. I don't want to redo this. I was so happy that it worked out. Alright, but seriously, if it is too bad, let me know and I'll redo it. But as long as it's not between June 28th and July like 5th or 6th, depending on how bad my recovery is after that playing that game. Anyway, questions, comments, and concerns down in the comments, and good luck on your projects. If you have anything else that you may want me to make a tutorial on, please feel free to suggest it and I'll take a look at it. If you want to donate that item, that'd be even greater because, you know, I'm totally broke. Tutorials don't pay, dudes. All right. That's enough talking. This has been Zero, and I hope I helped you out. Good luck and happy creating. Bye!